नमस्कार, दिस इज रोहित शंकर माने एंड यू आर वॉचिंग साइंटिस्ट आर एकेडमी टुवर्ड्स साइंटिफिक वर्ल्ड। नाउ वी हैव स्टार्टेड द मिल्क माइक्रोबायोलॉजी लेक्चर सीरीज एंड दिस इज आवर लेक्चर फर्स्ट। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मिल्क, कंपोजिशन ऑफ मिल्क एंड सोर्स ऑफ कंटामिनेशन। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर, इफ यू आर न्यू टू माई चैनल, सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल एंड क्लिक ऑन द बेल आइकॉन फॉर न्यू अपडेट्स। एंड इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो, लाइक एंड डू शेयर। So first we are going to understand about the definition of milk. Now milk is a lactate secretion practically free from colostrum obtained by complete milking of one or more healthy cows, which contains not less than 8.25 milk solids, not fat, and not less than 8.25% milk fat. So this is the standard definition obtained from the WHO. If we see the composition of milk, it mainly contains water, lactose, butterfat, casein, albumin and minerals. If we see the concentrations, water is around 87.5%, lactose is around 5%, butterfat 3.8%, casein is around 3.2%, albumin is around 0.7% and minerals is also 0.7%. So this composition is very important as far as the health of milk is concerned. Beside above components, milk also contains peptones, amino acids, nitrogen bases, fatty acids, sugar phosphates, proteases, enzymes and other sugars. It also contains vitamins such as vitamin A, B, C and D. Fresh milk contains lactoperoxidase and agglutinins, but when the milk becomes older, then these two components will become ineffective. Color of the milk is white, and it is white because of carotene which presents in the hay, grass and green leaves. Some carotene is converted into vitamin A while some part remains as it is, which gives color to the milk. So this is the composition and the definition of milk. If you see the normal flora of the milk, milk secreted into udders of healthy cow is sterile, and some saprophytic bacteria such as Micrococcus, Bacillus, Escherichia, Lactobacillus will be present. Fresh drawn milk shows the presence of lactic acid bacteria such as lactic acid or Lactobacillus casein, Lactobacillus acidophilus, Lactobacillus bulgaricus, Lactobacillus plantarum. In addition to this Lactobacillus, it also contains coliforms, leuconostoc, protease and pseudomonas bacteria. So this is all about the composition of milk. Now next point is the source of contamination in the milk. Now see, the milk is said to be a complete healthy food as far as the health of each and every person is concerned on the earth. It also contains high amount of water with the high amount of protein, carbohydrate and minerals, so which gives us a very healthy diet which improves our health. If the milk becomes contaminated, and if you are taking the contaminated milk, then we will be infectious, we will be get ill. So because of that we will suffer through the disease. So how it occurs, why it occurs, so that's what we are going to understand, source of contamination of milk. Now see how the contamination occurs. So when the entry or growth of non-pathogenic saprophytes occurs in the milk, that's what the contamination started. Now pathogenic microorganisms, pathogens means what? The disease causing organisms. Pathogens means what? Disease causing organism. So disease causing organism, when enters inside the milk, they start to grow inside the milk, and while growing they secrete toxins, and because of that milk get contaminated. So let's see what are the sources. So first source is animal, second milker, third is utensils, milking area and surrounding, fifth is water, sixth is cattle feed, and seventh is the fly. So these are the main seven sources of contamination in the milk. Now these all sources we are going to understand one by one. Let's see, first source is the animal. Now in this figure you can see the animal is staying in very dirty area. So that's what, the milk from udders of healthy cows is very sterile, but when it reaches and leaves teats of milk duct, it is contaminated by saprophytic bacteria. Now the saprophytic bacteria are those bacteria which are the total depends on the other material for their growth. known as saprophytic bacteria. So this saprophytic bacteria observed when the milk is come out. As the first milk contains hundreds to thousands of bacteria, it is generally discarded. For example, if the animal is itself is diseased, then that diseased that animal will secrete or that bacteria will come in that milk. For example, Streptococcus pyogenes transfer these organisms to the milk. Consumption of such milk develops infection like secret fever, septic sore throat, etc. Now we have to take precautions, like we have to clip the cow while having the milk. We have to grooming. We have to do the grooming of the cow, washing of the udder with warm water, and using pail or milking machine. Second point is the milker or dairyman. See, the dairyman is handling the cow while having the milk. So that's what the dairyman should be, clean in nature. See, while doing the milk or while removing the milk, the dairyman's or the milker's hands are close in contact with the cow. So that's all, that hand should be cleaned. If hands are contaminated or if hands have much more microorganisms, so that microorganisms will enter in the udder by udder indirectly to the milk. So that hands of the milker should be clean. Third point is the utensils. Now see, while having the milk or during the milking, we are using different types of utensils, and if these utensils are contaminated or some type of microorganism inside, then that will cause contamination in the milk. So the utensils which are used during the milking and for storing the milk includes pail and milking machine. Pail and what? Milking machine. Strainers, milk cans, or in modern dairy even pipelines. As a milkman collects raw milk and then distributes it to the consumer, chances of contamination higher during the storage, transport, and even distribution. Similarly, a dairy also collects raw milk from various sources, then cools it immediately, and then distributes it. So again, chances of contamination are very much higher. So that's what. Soil, dust, animal hair may contaminate the utensils, and that utensil may contaminate the milk. So that's what we have to clean. We have to clean the utensils as much as possible with the help of detergents or etc. And we have to take precautions while having the milking or during the milking, which utensils we have to use or utensils are cleaned or not. So next point is the milking area and the surrounding. Now see, the milking area and the surrounding include cow pen and barnyard. Now cow pen is a place where the animals are actually kept. Now we can see this cow pen. The sanitary conditions of cow pen is an important factor, and it is constantly loaded by the animal waste. It creates unsanitary conditions and hence causes contamination. Dusty air entering in cow pen is also another source of contamination, which may add thousands of microorganisms from outside environment. Next is the water. Now see, the water we are using while during the milking, that may contaminate the milk. So water is also a potential source of contamination. Because water is used for the cleaning purpose, and it is also used for the washing purpose of utensils, whatever the polluted are. So they will add the contamination, they will add the microorganisms to the milk. So that's what we have to take precautions about the water, which water we are going to use. Now next important, that is the cattle feeder. Now cattle feed may given in different forms as green fodder, fodder cakes, cotton seeds, and silage are used. Each of these forms are considered number of microorganisms, and this cattle feed should be clean from microorganisms. Now last one, that is the flies. Now flies are also contribute number of organisms because their contact with the animal waste cattle feed. They can also contaminate milk directly if milk cans are kept open. And we can see this figure. In this figure we can easily observe the flies on cow's mouth. So that's what we have to keep clean our cows and the area too. So we can do the restriction in the contamination, and we can keep our area and our cows and our milk clean. So these are the some source of contamination in the milk, and the definition of the milk and the composition of milk. If you have any doubt, you can comment or you can mail me. Thanks a lot.